Miss Gossiter, I know that's certainly a lie. Amazing person. She can sing. She not only knows English, she knows French. And enough to live, enough Spanish to survive in Mexico. I recently found out that she was named after an island in Scotland. That in itself is interesting. So right now our next speaker is Skye Gravenstuk.
Conception. A special clock has been marking the commencement of our lives. Tick tock. In the early 1990s, we, the up-and-coming generation of Long Beach, Mississippi, were finally born into this world. Afraid, disoriented, and hungry. Tick tock. In the later 1990s, we sobbed violently, screaming and pouting, mucking the brand new clothing that our exhausted parents dressed us in, the fresh supplies in our book bag becoming utterly disorganized. Despite our vehement protests, we lost the battle, and we entered that bright kindergarten classroom to begin our formal education. Tick tock. September 11th, 2001. Very few adults realize the effect that this date had on us all. Although we were only elementary schoolers, this attack on our great nation shook each of us to our very core. It was the first day that we learned of patriotism and recognized it as it boiled through our blood. But it was also the day that too young, the utopia that our innocent minds envisioned, was shattered. Tick tock. During these elementary and middle school years, we definitely remember to look forward to the little things. Pokemon came out in Game Boy Color, and that's probably why so many of us have such a terrible vision today. We little girls swooned over those hunky NSYNC men, and we argued over just who would get to marry Justin Timberlake. The boys were similarly obsessed with their new Nintendo GameCubes, and we were all completely enamored with the Angry Beavers, Tamagotchis, Harry Potter, and Jurassic Park. Life was good, even though we all looked horrendous in that 90s clothing. Tick tock. August 2005. In less than 24 hours, Long Beach was decimated. At 11, 12, 13, 14 years old, everything was ripped away from us. We experienced our first heart-wrenching grief, our first brutal loss. But through the debris and the terror, we grew. In the days following Hurricane Katrina, each of us aged by a decade, and we accepted our responsibility as citizens of this earth far sooner than most. Our hands grew calloused with rebuilding efforts, and our muscles strengthened as we lifted case after case of bottled water into our neighbor's cars. For the very first time, we as a generation were adults. Tick tock. We enter our high school years with a seemingly endless stretch of challenging classes, mind-boggling tests, and strenuous evenings of research paper writing ahead of us. What these years give to us, it's not just that diploma that we work tirelessly towards, but character. Each year gifts us with fresh wisdom, new friendships, and unforgettable experiences. Whether 3 days from now is your graduation, like me, or if you still have years left, one thing is for certain. The 4 years of high school pass truly in the blink of an eye. The class of 2011 knows as well tonight, as we prepare to say goodbye to the classmates, the friends who have given us belonging, companionship, and love these past 13 years. does seem like time has run out. But today does not mark the end. Our history gives us the fuel and the inspiration to make a lasting difference in this world. Today is the day that we ignite. The years of our life before today have simply been preparation to build the fire that will fuel us for the rest of our lives. Today, we step across that barrier between childhood and the expansive future that lies before us. Today, we catch fire. Our generation, each of us, we are on the threshold of ignominious opportunities. We are young. We are intelligent. We are vibrant. We are strong. And we are capable. And there is nothing that can withstand our flame if we fight for success. Success is not the result of spontaneous combustion. We must set ourselves on fire. Each of you is made up of a vast array of influences, differences, and talents. Each of you is powerful, and each of you has a future ahead of you if only you will be fierce and fight for it. We as a generation have the power within us to make a lasting change in the climate of our planet. As the clock ticks away the years, I want each of us to become magnificent in our success, but also to be humbled by the differences we make in the lives of our fellow man. But most of all, I want us to be the torchbearers of a legacy of pride, honor, love, selflessness, and of course, that Long Beach excellence. Long Beach, Mississippi, up-and-coming generation, burn so brightly that the entire planet can be aflame. Never be extinguished. Thank you.